Good evening. It's my pleasure to welcome each and every one to our Sunday evening worship service. Tonight we'll be worshiping in song. For all faithful men who wish to lead a song, we'd ask you to prepare that and be ready at the appropriate time, and we'll sing tonight and worship in song. Our first song tonight is number 191. 191.
Savior, lead me lest I stray.
Number 298, 298. After this song, we'll have our prayer, 298.
Buried with Christ, my blessed Redeemer, dead to the old life of folly and sin, Satan may cover.
Richly shared it with me, that is our word. Would you bow with me, please? Our Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for all the blessings that you give to us. Our Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for Jesus and what he did for each one of us, going to that cruel cross and dying for our sins. Our Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for all the brothers and sisters who attend here. We're so thankful for the love and the common bond that we each share. Our Heavenly Father, we pray that you always give us and help us find the escape of our temptations, whatever they may be. Our Heavenly Father, we have so many that are traveling, that are out and about, and Heavenly Father, we ask that you be with each one of them. Please be with each one of them, and if it's your will, please keep them safe. Our Heavenly Father, we ask that you be with our elders of this congregation. Our Heavenly Father, we're so lucky and blessed to have each one of them. And Heavenly Father, we ask that you continue to be with each one of these men. Help them to always look at your word and see how to lead us. Our Heavenly Father, we ask that you be with each one of us now. And as we sing these songs of praise to you, we ask that we pay attention to the words and edify each other. Heavenly Father, we pray all these things in Christ's name. Amen.
Number 152.
152. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus.
Number 255. After this, the next one can be ready. 255.
Everything to God in prayer.
like to mark our invitation song. It's number 256, 256.
Number 113. It's a little different. I'm usually up here with a Bible. I figured I'd give it a shot. 113.
I need thee every hour, most gracious Lord. No tender voice like thine, and peace afford. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to thee. I need thee every hour, most holy one. Oh, make me thine indeed, thou blessed Son. I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to thee.
Number 568. 568. This was my brother's favorite song, and it's one of my favorites, so sing out. O beautiful star of Bethlehem, shining afar through shadows dim, guiding the light to those who long have gone, guiding the wise men on their way out to the place where Jesus lay. Star of Bethlehem, shine on. O beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine upon us until the glory dawn. Oh, give us the light to light the way into the land where perfect day. Beautiful star of Star, the hope of rest for the redeemed, the good and blessed, yonder in glory when the crown is won. For Jesus is now that star divine, brighter and brighter he will shine. Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on. Beautiful star.
Number 42, 42. This is a stand-up song, so we'll need to stand up. Faith is a victory.
Encamped along the hills of mighty Christian soldiers rise, and Christ the battle and the land shall bear the glowing skies. Against the falling bells below, faith is a victory we know.
Next hymn is number 43, the same opening. I don't think I've ever led this song before. I think most of us know it though. 43, Faith of Our Fathers.
Faith of our fathers lives still, in spite of dungeon or fire and sword. Oh, how our hearts beat high with joy whenever we hear that glorious word. Faith of our fathers, holy faith, we shall be true to thee till death. Our fathers chained in prison's dark were still in heart and conscience free. How sweet would be their children's faith if they like them could die.
Number 390. 390. If for the price we have striven, after our labors are o'er, rested our souls will be given on the eternal shore. Home of the soul, beautiful home, there we shall rest, never to roam, free from all care, happy and bright. Jesus is there, He is the light. Oft in the storm, lonely are we, sighing for home, longing for Thee. Beautiful home of the ransomed, beside the crystal sea. Soon the bright homeland adorning, we shall behold the glad dawn. Lean on the Lord till the morning, trust till the night is gone. Home of the soul, beautiful home, there we shall rest, never to roam, free from all care, happy and bright. Jesus is there, He is the light. Oft in the storm, lonely are we, sighing for home, longing for Thee. Beautiful home of the ransomed, beside the crystal sea. Number 490. 490. Angels are singing redemption's sweet song. Wonderful thing, glorious thing. Shout the glad message and join in the throne, singing redemption song. Sing the sweet story, redemption.
nations with song. Over and over the chorus prolong. Shout the glad message and join with the throng. Ever will sing praise to the King, singing redemption song. Joy beyond measures us wakes us up there. Wonderful thing, glorious thing, soon we shall join with the angels up there, singing redemption song. Sing the sweet story, redemption sweet song. Over and over, chorus prolong. Shout the glad message and join with the throng. Ever we'll sing praise to the King, singing redemption song.
Number 38.
Down at the cross where my Savior died, down for the cleansing from sin I cried. There to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to His name. There's a beautiful place called heaven. It's hidden above the bright blue, where the good who from earth ties are riven, live in love and eternity through. Above the bright blue, the beautiful blue, Jesus is waiting for me and for you. Heaven is there, not far from our sight. beautiful city of light. We know not he shall call us, whether soon the glad summons shall be. But we know when we pass on the river, the glory of Jesus we'll see. Above the bright blue, the beautiful blue, Jesus is waiting for me and for you. Heaven is there, not far from our sight. Beautiful city of light.
Got time for one. 149.
Nearer still, nearer, close to thy heart. Draw me, my Savior, so precious thou art. Fold me, oh, fold me close to thy breast. Shelter me safe in that haven of rest. Shelter me safe in that haven of rest. Nearer still, nearer, nothing I bring, not as an offering to Jesus my King. Only my sinful now contrite heart,
grant me a cleansing thy blood doth impart. Grant me the cleansing thy blood.
Yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him and he with me. To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. Revelation chapter 3, verses 20 through 21. These last three verses of Revelation 3, in Jesus' address to seven churches of Asia, we see these words as an invitation. Jesus knocks at the door and is up to those he is addressing to open and allow him to enter. When we open the door to Jesus, we have fellowship with Jesus. If the door is closed, we are none of his. The door before which Jesus is standing is not a physical door, but the door of your heart. We have a popular invitation song entitled, Who at the Door is Standing? Who at the door is standing? Jesus is standing at that door. He stands at the door every day. Jesus is merciful. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a living hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Jesus is patient. And the Lord direct your hearts into the love of God and into the patience of Christ. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 5. Jesus is loving. And walk in love, even as Christ also have loved us and have given himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling savor. Ephesians 5, verse 2. Jesus knocks on that door. He doesn't barge in. Jesus invites. In Matthew 11, verses 28 through 30, the Bible reads, Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give ye rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Jesus reasons, but sanctify the Lord in your hearts and be ready always to give an answer to every man that asks you a reason of the hope that is in you with meekness and fear. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 15. Jesus persuades. Knowing therefore the terror or fear of the Lord, we persuade men, but we are made manifest unto God. And I trust also are made manifest in your consciousness, our conscience. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 11. In the end, it is our choice as to whether to open the door or not. The world is standing at the door. They are in need of salvation, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. John chapter 3, verse 17. Only Jesus can satisfy their spiritual needs. Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. John chapter 14, verse 6. We, as Jesus' people, Christians, have an opportunity to knock on behalf of Jesus. Jesus gives us an opportunity. I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. For thou hast a little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name. Revelation chapter 3, verse 8. We must teach others that word. Last, you are standing at the door. Individually, each of us is standing on the other side of this door. It is the sinner. Jesus said unto them, I came not to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. Luke chapter 5, verse 32. It is the unfaithful Christian. As many as I love, I reprove and chasten. Be zealous, therefore, and repent. Revelation chapter 3, verse 19. It is the faithful Christian. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee the crown of life. Revelation 2, verse 10. We hear the knocks of Jesus as God's word is presented to us. We hear the knocks of those who are living the word around us. Even so, let your light shall shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Matthew chapter 5, verse 16. We hear the knocks of the one who is teaching Jesus' word, and as he reasoned of righteousness and self-control and the judgment to come, Felix was terrified and answered, Go thy way for this time, And when I have a convenient season, I will call thee, unto me. Acts chapter 24, verse 25. We hear the knocks of the word in our own private study and devotion. But what saith it? The word is nigh thee, in thy mouth, in thy heart, that is the word of faith which we preach. Romans chapter 10, verse 8. How do we respond to these knocks? Jesus knocks this very hour. Is your door open or closed? If you are not a Christian this evening, Jesus is knocking at your door. He is saying for you to obey his gospel and become a Christian today. One must hear the word, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Romans 10, verse 17. You must believe with all your heart, but without faith it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is the rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. You must repent of your sins. Acts 17, verse 30 says, in the times of this ignorance God winked at, but now commandeth all men everywhere to repent. You must confess that Jesus is the Son of God. Matthew 16, verse 16. And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And finally, you must be baptized for the remission of your sins. Mark 16, verse 15 and 16. And the Lord will add you to his church. Acts 2, verse 47. Tonight, you have an opportunity to respond to the invitation as we stand and sing.
Who at the door is standing, patiently drawing near, entrance within.
Good day at the Lord's Church in Bremen. For all those who have a public part in our worship this morning and this evening, we're thankful for your efforts. For all those who may be visiting with us, you're honored guests. We invite you back at every opportunity you have to be with us. Please take a moment, fill out an attendance card. If you were not here this morning, give it to one of us as you leave so that we may have a record of your visit with us today. Remind you of those that we mentioned this morning. On our prayer list, you're asked to continue to remember Sister Florian King as she recovers from recent surgery at home. She's been making some incremental progress, and we hope that she will continue to do so. Helen Head has some surgery upcoming this week. You're asked to remember her. Charlotte Vines, Eileen Brannon's sister, also had recent successful hip replacement. She has some therapy upcoming, but so far so good as far as Charlotte Vines. Shirley Smallwood has some more therapy upcoming. Hopefully she can go through some therapy and avoid surgery. She'll have several therapy sessions upcoming. Are there others that we should mention? Brothers Keepers Group 2, Ricky and Cindy's group, will host the Last of Leaders Award reception and dinner, suppose, that will be after the evening service next Sunday, April the 7th, Finger Foods of the Fair. And the entire congregation is invited to this and asked to bring finger foods for that event. Spoke with Brother Johnny this morning, and he said they had a fabulous time at Last of Leaders this past weekend, which concluded late last night. A lot of the folks got in very late last night. But he is in the process of preparing a comprehensive review and all the pictures that goes along with it. It'll be a few weeks before we're able to present that, but that is coming. So a lot of folks want to know who did what and so forth. We do have that in preparation, and Johnny will be presenting that shortly. But again, after the evening service, next Sunday, April the 7th, will be the Last of Leaders Awards Finger Foods after the evening service next Sunday. The Ladies Devo is this coming Thursday morning, right? This coming Thursday morning at 11 o'clock, Finger Foods are the fair. Brothers Keepers Group 4, this is Robert and Cheryl's group. We'll meet at Chad and Reagan's house on April the 6th. That's this coming Saturday, right? This coming Saturday at 5 p.m. Breakfast items are for dinner. Also make your visitation card that evening. Again, Brothers Keepers Group 4, Robert Cheryl's group will meet next door at Chad and Reagan's house this coming Saturday, 5 p.m. Breakfast items are the fare for dinner. Make sure you bring your visitation card that evening. Hopefully you're well familiar with our gospel meeting, which is rapidly approaching. It will be beginning the final Sunday of next month, which is tomorrow, April the 28th. The last Sunday of April is the beginning of our gospel meeting here with Brother Ronnie Whittemore of Indianapolis, Indiana. You've heard him speak before. He spoke on our summer series last summer via DVD, but he's spoken here before. It's been several years ago, but he's an excellent speaker, and you should hopefully making your plans for that event. We'd also like to establish that Sunday, since we'll have a potluck after the morning service, as we typically do for the beginning of our spring gospel meeting, we'll have a gold day. This morning, we had just shy of 200 folks here this morning. So let's set a goal of 250 for the first Sunday of our gospel meeting and the kickoff for that event that will go through Thursday, May the 1st, 7 p.m., 7:30 that Sunday night, 7 p.m. each evening through Thursday, May the 1st. So let's set a goal day of 250. Begin to invite your friends and family and neighbors and co-workers and so forth now, and be persistent and see if we can meet our goal of 250 that Sunday morning. The Lord's Supper is kept prepared for those that wish to observe it. Once we stand to sing, go through this door, second door on the left, and there will be someone there waiting to serve you. Again, our next service, Lord willing, will be Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. We hope to see each of you at that time. Should we mention anything else? Number 516 will be our final song. 516. I ask you to stand and we'll sing and be dismissed.
To Christ be loyal and be true, His pattern be.
Please bow. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for blessing us with such great singing tonight, and please help us to go out from today, and please help us to encourage one another, to help encourage others to come and convince them to become Christians. Please be with us all through our daily walks of life, and please help us all to reflect every bit of Christ that we should. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.